The first crappie recipe we're gonna do this evening is what we like to call spicy Japanese crispy crappie. Get them all in the bottom of your bowl. I'm gonna kind of spread these out a little bit. And this next step is the most important one, because the idea is, you know, since we're fixing to use panko breadcrumbs, which are dry, crunchy breadcrumbs, they have to stick to that filet. And in order for that to stick, we're just gonna pat dry all these filets in the bottom of that bowl. We want them nice and sticky. We'll move them around, get all the water out. No water. And this is a good step for any kind of frying. If you're using any kind of batter whatsoever, this is a really good thing to do. We're gonna break out the black pepper, and we're not gonna use it sparingly. Heavy, heavy, heavy on the black pepper. Now you're probably saying, why in the world would you put that much black pepper on there? It's because when I put my egg wash on, and once I mix them all up, get that egg wash on them real good and thick, most of that black pepper isn't gonna be there. We're gonna start out with one egg. What this egg wash does, it helps these panko crumbs to stick to that crappie. Without this, it will not stick. They will fall off, so you must use the egg wash. We'll get that egg wash all over those fish, like so. Kind of just get a feel for it. Just kind of mix it around. All right, the next thing we're gonna do, we're gonna take our panko breadcrumbs. Now, and this is the case for all types of frying. You don't wanna put your flour, cornmeal, breadcrumbs, whatever you're frying with, wait till the last minute to put that on those fish, and they'll fry up a lot lighter and crispier. So we got us a pan full of panko. And now we're gonna head to the fryer. So all we're gonna do is we're just gonna roll it in them pankos. And if you got a basket fryer, don't lay them in the bottom of the basket. Drop them straight in the grease, that way they won't stick together. And this ain't gonna take but about 3 minutes. And they will be done. As soon as you take them out of the grease, as soon as you take them out, go ahead and dust them with that essence. While that grease is still wet on there, that seasoning stick a lot better. Fish dip. So we're gonna start out with mayonnaise. You say, how much? I say, you got a bunch of fat boys standing around you, a bunch of it. Horseradish sauce. You say, how much horseradish sauce you put in there? Well, that's according to how much you like horseradish. If you like horseradish, put a bunch of it in there. Dijon mustard, lemon juice, not much. A little Worcestershire, whatever kind of seasoning you like. Old Bay blackened seasoning. I'm gonna go heavy, heavy, heavy on that. We're just gonna stir it all up. Should get a light brown texture here, or color. You can add relish to it if you want it to be more like a tartar sauce, but I like a little creamy dipping sauce. All right, let's see what we got. Yep, we're good. And this is what we call our Japanese style crappie with our world famous fish dip. Hope you enjoy it. What about it?
You know, I thought that was great. It is. It just makes it phenomenal.
Mm-hmm.